Howdy, welcome to Let's Play IL-2 Stromovic with me, CXPKNOBB, using pilot engine overheat, continuing on with our long career of German fighter campaign in the northern Europe, mostly in Finland area, Leningrad area, and now we're backed up to Frankfurt on the Oder, next to Berlin. April 15, 1945. 3:30 in the afternoon, weather is clear, clouds at 500. If the weather is clear, there's no clouds, so I don't even have to look at this. Anyway, our friends from the strike group are performing attack in Devno, New Dom area. I guess that's up here somewhere. Somewhere up here. There you go, Devno, Prentice, New Dom. It's a small city between a river and a road, it seems. Our bombers will attack Russian airfield. You must protect the bombers. So the airfield is over here somewhere. This looks like mountains, these gray lines. I don't know why they built an airfield next to a mountain. But we're gonna be escorting some bombers. I don't know what bombers they are, how many of them they are. But I know they'll be heading over this direction. We're not doing the bombing. There's no bomb icon. And it clearly says we must protect the bombers. So we're not the bombers, we're the escorts. So it's a little less dangerous for us than if we were to bomb the airfield, because that's probably the most dangerous kind of missions there are in this game. So it's 42 clicks to the distance, Alpha to 3000. There'll be four of us escorting. I don't know what we'll be escorting, but we'll be not Russian pilots, will be German DE5. How's that? Everything here is fine. Let's take about 60% fuel. No bombs. Just head north. That's it. The bombers will find the air base. Hopefully we can save few of them. Hopefully they can bomb whatever they need to bomb. And hopefully few of them will make it back home. Hopefully all of us will make it back home. Ah, are these the bombers? BF-109s. Let's take a look at them. Do they have bombs? Yeah, they got a bomb underneath them. Underneath the fuselage. Yeah, these are BF-109s. Four of them. No one behind us. Clear sky up there. This is a nice airfield. Nice and big. Let's go. I'm gonna lower the flaps. Turn on my lights. Start the right engine. What are these airplanes? More BF-109s. Yeah, we had a long career. We flew two different types of BF-109s. We flew two different types of FW-190s. Now we are flying the new and the best airplane. ME262s. The jet planes. Of course, you can never say these are the best airplanes for any airplane, because there's no such thing as the best airplane. Some anti-aircraft guns out there. A little bit misty out there by the mountains. But we'll be heading north, which is to my 8 o'clock, right over there somewhere. Under these lights. So I have the nose wheel, so my plane is pitching straight forward when I'm on the ground, so I have a very good visibility in front of us when we're on the ground. This actually is a very nice plane. The engines are a little finicky. But once you master the engines, and this airplane is very good for just about anything. Let's try to stay in the runway. Good. I'm pitching up. I'm just wait and the plane will go up. So no one else is flying today, just the BF-109s and then us four. Frankfurt under order. There we go. The bombers, BF-109s, are turning northward already. Let's follow them. Raise up the flaps. We actually don't need these external lights, the navigation lights. The left side, port side, is red. Right side, the starboard side, is green. If you see a plane at night, they'll have these lights on. And if you see the green light, you'll know that the starboard side. If you see the red light, you'll know that's the port side. And the plane will most likely be traveling forward, so you know which direction the plane is going, even though you can't see the plane itself in the dark night sky. So I think there's another light in the back. There's a white light in the back. I don't know how that is in real life, or nowadays I should say. But the lights are off. We're not ascending too quickly, so our engines are not yet overheating. So all these gauges are color-coded. Everything white means good. If anything staying in white is good. Anything other than white is bad. So it's very easy to figure out. We're gonna overshoot these guys because we are hella faster than BF-109s under just about any circumstances, except for maybe when ascending and accelerating. And they may be able to overshoot us because our engines will overheat. Once we get up in the air, nothing can touch us. Not the Mustangs. Not the Yaks. Not anything. So those are the bombers. Keeping an eye out. But altitude 1700 right now. I don't know if the bombers will ascend any higher than that. They'll probably be flying at altitude 500 meters. The briefing want us flying at altitude 3000. But altitude 2000 right now. That will get us farther up and farther away from the bombers. I'm not sure why they want us that. Maybe they're expecting the enemy interceptors to be at altitude 3000. At any rate, we're gonna have to climb up that high. That's my number 2, number 4, and number 3 is between them somewhere. Keep an eye out on the sky for any dots. So German anti-aircraft guns shooting at something up there. Probably Russian airplanes. Probably somewhere right over there. I don't see anything out there. We're still going full throttle. We're just about full throttle. Now to 2400. Bombers directly underneath us. We're weaving left and right. Now the bombers will almost always be going slower than the escorts. Doesn't mean you should slow down unless your engine is overheating. That means you need to weave left and right or circle around and don't get too far ahead of them. So you do need to keep an eye on your bombers. Those green tracers from the ground, I'm gonna turn around here. Oh, no, never mind. Yak down there, red 2, he says. I see two dots out there. They're flying, I lost them, but they're flying over that direction to the east. I'm not sure it would be smart for us to chase them or not. We're at altitude 3700, we're up very high. So I'm actually gonna turn around here. Do like a figure eight kind of deal. Descent to altitude 3,000. No need to be higher up than that. I don't know what town that is. Oh, that's an airbase. Is that the airbase? Are we there already? Alright, it's the other half of the figure eight. Well, I don't know where Newdom is. That may be it right there. Whoa, number four is going crazy. Some field out there. That's a city right there. That's the city next to a river and a road. But that destroys many cities. But yeah, this is indeed the airbase that these guys are gonna bomb. EF-49s are in the line formation. They are spreading apart. They're up with the bomb, the shit out of them. Here are the legs. And here are the yaks. Alright, it's our job to get the fighters. The yaks are the legs. Legs are the bigger threat to the bombers. Yaks are the bigger threat to us. No, actually, the lags are pulling up, so we're gonna try to get the hell away from here. Alright, meanwhile, the bombing's going on. Bomb something down there. Now, it's not in our best interest to fight over the enemy airbase. These yaks are coming for me. I'm gonna have to just fly straight and try to. No, they're coming for number two. I gotta help out number two then. Oh, number two got someone. Another one of the yaks. Red number one, the leader. Now I should be able to get the red number two. Gotta keep an eye out for the lags. They're out there. Guy's going to the left. Can't really see him. I see him now. He's trying to climb up. Bad decision. Goodbye. Yeah, you don't want to pull up in front of enemy 262. BF-109s are still hanging around the enemy airbase, which is not good. I want to pull my guys away from the airbase. I don't really want to go there, but the BF-109s are still sticking around. So we have no choice to be in this danger zone. Get shot at. Try to weave between the bullets here. There were at least four lags out there. Okay, there's, I see three of them. One of them might have gotten shot down. All right, let's go get him. Yeah, I don't see lag number one out there. So number two is pulling out. Number three, number four. Stalling right here. What did I just say? Don't pull up in front of Invitation to 2s. You don't want to be a standing still target. Right, lag number 2. Oh, that's lag number 1. He was running away. Alright, hopefully the BF-109s are safe somewhere. To be honest, I didn't see that many of them out there. Beautiful and nice. Alright, my number 3 is down there somewhere. He's getting shot at by lag number 4 or 2. He's being chased by lag number 3. Number 1 and 2 are pulling behind me, so I don't have that much time right here. But I'm gonna take my shot at. Yeah. I'm gonna pull away from the lags. Shit exploded. I gotta be careful. 1 and 2 might be right behind me, but I think I'm fast enough to run away from them. Meanwhile, my teammates should be coming up behind them. It's a lot easier if you had a smarter teammates. Alright, my number 3 is down there, I believe, and my number 4 is up there. My number 2 is hopefully where somewhere I can't see. Hopefully he's alive somewhere. And I saw BF-109 number 4, that's not my number 2. Number 4 on the other side of the airbase. I don't know if he made it back. And I don't know about the other 3 BF-109s, but there's a good chance that most of them got shot down. Because it's extremely dangerous. Right on top of the enemy airbase. That's it. How are we doing with fuel? We have plenty of fuel. We have about 800 liters in each engine. It's a Russian pilot. This is parachute. I'm coming up behind these guys. 2.6 clicks away. I'll trim my plane down a bit. The altitude 2,000 meters. These guys are pulling a bit to the left. Are my guys chasing? A little lag pursuit here on the lags. Gotta be careful not to fly back into the enemy airbase. Alright, right here. It's pulling up. I just gonna stabilize my plane. Number 2, you get it, man. Stop following me. By default, I think my number 2 always chases me until he gets fired upon. Number 4 just shot someone down? Maybe. I still don't know if this is a new Devna? I don't know what the city is. Well, I can check by looking at the map here. No, this is Kirsten. This is some other city. So I don't think we ever actually found the city that we were supposed to be looking for. This guy going down? Yeah, this guy's going down. That guy shot down. We are done. You want to take a closer look at the parachute? Hopefully there's no anti-aircraft guns hidden in the city. But we're done here. We're gonna fly southward. I just heard some explosion. Number 5? Who's number 5? There's no number 5 in the flight. But he's landing apparently. Alright, we're gonna fly south. Just down that direction. So our magical compass. Alright, I don't know what our cruise RPM is supposed to be, but those 2 meters are the RPMs. There's a sweet spot between how fast I should go and how much drag will slow me down, and where the fuel is most efficient and nothing gets overheated. And there's a sweet spot between all of those, and that is the cruise RPM. So you set your throttle and your altitude and whatnot to so your engine spins at the constant RPM. But I don't know what that is for this airplane. Doesn't really matter too much because we are not in much danger and we have plenty of fuel and we have short distance to go. There is already Frankfurt under order right in front of us, and that white spot is our airbase. My guys are following me. Where's number 3? I see number 2 and number 4. Oh no, I think our number 3 might not be making back with us. I did see him during the dogfight. I didn't see him on the flight out there, and I don't see him on the flight back. I don't expect to find any threats up here. I'm just gonna some time compression. Start slowing down my plane. I have to throttle down very gently, very slowly. Someone's flying out there at altitude 4,500 feet or meters. 4,500 meters. Alright. That's not our airbase. That is our airbase right there to our left. Gonna tell my guys to navigate. No, tactical. Number 3, return to base. Yeah, number 3 is not responding. Number 2, number 4 are returning to base. So number 3 is probably shot down somewhere. Don't know if he survived the crash. If he died. Anyway, he's not coming. Or he's not going to be landing right now. In our airbase. Very tricky part of this airplane is landing it. This airplane, you can't really count on the acceleration on this airplane because you can't throttle up quickly. Because if you do, the engines will explode. So if you end up landing too short, you're screwed. For other planes, if you think you're coming too short, all you gotta is throttle up, pitch back up, and do another pass by. But this airplane, that's not an option. So you gotta make sure you land not too short of the runway. And of course you can't be going too fast, otherwise you'll overshoot the runway. Because this plane is built for speed. So I'm not quite sure what the best approach to land this airplane is. I'm going way too fast right now. I'm still going too fast. I'm gonna do a circle. It's the top compression. Someone flying by. Yeah, now I'm not going fast enough. I'm almost stalling right now. Yeah, there's a front side slats, front edge slats or whatever. And I'm stalling, almost stalling. The leading edge slats, that's what it is, I think. Anyway, number 2 is landing. I wanna land. I need to land. I'm running out of airspeed here. Well, I'm gonna try to land behind him, I guess. Fiat, I guess that was number 5 that was landing. I use the flaps to help me. Yeah, they gave both number 2 and myself permission to land on the same landing strip. This angry German control tower guy is net bright. Flaps will help me stabilize my airplane, grab some more air, help me fly better at low speed. That's exactly what I need at this point. And of course it'll slow me down as well. Number 2. Slower than I am. So it's gonna be close. It's my wheel brakes. Oh, good thing the guy turned out that way. I'm gonna follow the guy. He seems to know what he's doing. Alright, so my flaps. four circling around. That's a Fiat. I'm gonna turn off my left engine. Can actually use my right engine to spin me. Oh. Spin me to the left a bit. Turn it off. Force landing, I don't know. Abort approach. No, give him. What's wrong with this? Say air traffic controller tower guy. There's no one in there. I don't know why he's not giving number four the permission to land, because there's no one on the landing strip. Anyway, I don't know if the VF-109 has made it. VF-109 made it. VF-109 crashed here on his way back, so maybe he might have run out of fuel on his way back. That's my number three. He got shot down. I don't know. What's his name? Clink. He's wounded in action, so he survived. But he'll be out of the action for at least a few days. The war's gonna be ending in a few days, so he's alright. VF-109, K4. Three of them got shot down there. Fourth one got crashed there. So none of the VF-109s actually made it back home. Too bad. Hopefully this pilot survived. Hopefully some of these pilots survived. I don't know. They got shot down at pretty low altitude. The Lags got shot down. The Yak-9Ts. Ts are the ones with the big... These two are the Yak-9Ts. Ts are the ones with the big guns. I think they were designed to destroy tanks. I think that's why it's T. I don't know. Lag 3, the other two. Okay, I see a blue parachute. Okay, Clint did bail out. Yeah, he's survived. He's wounded in action. So we actually never made it to Depno, New Dam. I guess the airbase was out here. I don't know where. I think it's right here, the airbase. Just over the other side of the front. We did pass by this Kostrin, I don't know. But we did quite well. We got 3 kills. Saddle number 2, he got 1 kill. Clint, he's wounded in action. Klimper, he got 2 kills. We lost 5 planes. Those 4 of them are the BF-109. 5th one is the ME-262, my number 3. And we lost 6 airplanes. 4 Lag 3s and 2 Yak-9Ts, and I don't know, I don't think they destroyed anything on the enemy airbase. This mission wasn't that a great success, but at least we got some kills. Blah 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 blah, good deal.